Hi, I'm Mike Rankin, Editor-in-Chief of InDesignSecrets.com, and in this video, I'll show you how to select all the text to the end of a story in InDesign. To show how this works and why you might need to select to the end of a story, I have three documents open here. And these will eventually be three chapters in a book. But right now, the text for all three chapters is here in the Chapter 1 document. And if I go to the last page of the document, you can see some of the text from Chapter 2, but there's actually a lot more that you can't see because it's overset. There's more text than will fit in these text frames. And you know that there's overset text from the presence of this little red plus sign down here at the bottom of the text frame. So what I want to do is to cut all the text that comes after the end of Chapter 1, even though I can't see it all and I can't select it here in the layout. Now, one thing I could do is to open this story in the story editor. So I'll put my cursor in the story and choose Edit, Edit in Story Editor, or press Command Y here on the Mac or Control Y on Windows. And in the story editor, I can see where the overset text begins by this line right here. And I can click and drag to select past that. But that's still going to be a tedious manual way to get this text where I need it to be. A better way is to use the keyboard shortcut for selecting to the end of the story, which will grab all the text, including overset text. So I'll start by closing the story editor and put my cursor right before the start of Chapter 2. And the shortcut is Command-Shift-End here on the Mac, or Control-Shift-End on Windows. Now, you may be looking at your keyboard and thinking, well, I don't have an end key. Well, that's no problem, because there are usually other keys that you can press to invoke the end function. Like on my Mac keyboards, I use the function key plus the right arrow. So to select to the end of a story, I press Command-Shift-Function, right arrow. And it works in the other direction too. So I could press Command-Shift-Function, left arrow, to select all the text to the beginning of a story. But again, here I want to select the text that comes after Chapter 1 to cut it from this document. So I'll press my right arrow key to put my cursor right back where it was, and then I'll press Command-Shift-Function, right arrow. I'll press Command-X to cut the text, go to my Chapter 2 document, and paste. And then I can go to the last page, find the start of Chapter 3, and do the same thing again, Command-Shift-Function, right arrow, to select to the end. Cut it, go to the Chapter 3 document, paste, and so on. And remember, I'm just using the function and arrow keys on my Mac to invoke the home and end commands. If your keyboard has home and end keys, you could just use those instead. Thanks for watching this video, and if you want lots more tips like this, be sure to check out InDesignSecrets.com and subscribe to InDesign Magazine.